Good morning, everybody. Dr. Busy Riley coming at you live from the den of insanity, aka my office. Hey, I've been thinking about something and I'm going to reshare a blog post that I wrote earlier in the year about why I think most women are having too many periods. I really want us to consider during our 40s and 50s, if we're still bleeding, the difference between our biology and what we're built for and the way that we actually live our lives right now. Our biology is still such that we live in caves, but we have refrigerators and homes and options for controlling our contraception and our bleeding. And so when you really start to think about it, women are not designed to have a period every month for however many years we're doing that. Most people that I know don't have as many kids as their physiology will allow. Most people are choosing how many kids they wanna have. And when they're not pregnant or nursing, they are having a monthly menstrual period. The problem with this is that historically, women were designed to procreate and have children. And so being pregnant and nursing consistently often will suppress the period. So what does that mean for us? What I tend to see is that a lot of my women patients are very, very, very low in their iron stores. And this can contribute to things like not only superficial things like thinning hair and your appearance, but it can cause fatigue, anxiety. Sleep disruption is a really big one that I see. And so I'm gonna repost a link at the bottom of this video to my blog, and I'd love it if you guys would read that. And then I also just wanna let you know, if you're someone that has heavy periods and you're in your early 40s or late 30s, there are a lot of options for managing that. I know I'm the disappointing naturopath to tell people that you should get an IUD or use hormonal contraception. You don't always have to go there, but at the very least, please make sure that you're getting your iron stores checked and that you're getting them brought up, because I really think that's a big piece of the puzzle for quality of life. And when you're iron deficient and you're fatigued, then you're going to be cranking more stress hormones in order to meet the demands, the energy demands of your daily life. So really encourage you to read this piece. Let me know what you think. Please advocate for yourself with your physicians. Talk to them about ideas for suppressing the period, maybe suppressing your bleeding a little bit if you're a heavy bleeder. Talk about options, right? So it's all about choosing the tool that fits the need. I'm Dr. Busy Riley. Live like you give a damn.